Hello everyone. Thanks to everyone for watching this video. My name is Qi Dang. I am an architect and engineer. Today's video is titled Cable State Bridge, and it is going to provide you fundamentals of cable state bridge and also the optimal design procedure for the very long span bridge. I am going to give you an overview of what I am covering today's video. First and at all, it is a bit of background to the topic, and then focus on the optimization approaches for the long span design and mathematics of the layout optimization before wrapping up with conclusions. Okay, a cable stay bridge has one or more towers or pylons from which cables support the bridge deck. A distinctive feature are the cables or stays, which run directly from the tower to the deck, normally forming a fan-like pattern or a series of parallel lines. This is in contrast to the modern suspension bridge, where the cables supporting the deck are suspended vertically from the main cable, anchored at both ends of the bridge and running between the towers. The cable stay bridge is optimal for spans longer than cantilever bridges and shorter than suspension bridges. This is the range within which cantilever bridges would rapidly grow heavier, and suspension bridge cabling would be more costly. Although long span bridges have traditionally employed suspension or cable stay forms, comprising vertical pylons and networks of cables supporting a bridge deck. However, the optimality of such forms over very long spans appears never to have been rigorously assessed, and the theoretically optimal form for a given span carrying gravity loading has remained unknown. To address this, we here describe a new numerical layout optimization procedure capable of modeling the self-weight of the constituent structural elements, and use this to identify the form requiring the minimum volume of material for a given span. Now we can try to introduce layout optimization. The standard weightless layout optimization procedure involves discretizing a design domain with a series of nodes, usually positioned on a uniform grid. These nodes are interconnected with potential truss elements, forming a ground structure, and optimization is then used to find the minimum volume truss structure satisfying force equilibrium conditions. We can see the right-hand side example. The design domain is discretized with nodes and assumed boundary and load conditions. Then layout of straight elements is identified via layout optimization. To take account of the effects of self-weight, the standard formulation can be modified to include elements with equal strength along their length. So straight elements are replaced with suitably curved compression and tension members. When using layout optimization, the solution accuracy is controlled by the number of nodes used to discrete the design domain. If large numbers of nodes are employed, then highly accurate numerical solutions can be obtained. However, the forms will often be complex and also difficult to realize in practice. To address this, a relatively coarse nodal discretization can instead be used to obtain a layout that can then be improved by adjusting the locations of nodes using the geometry optimization procedure. Now we can use the new layout optimization to identify layout of curved elements, and the curved elements may lie slightly outside the domain. Then improve design obtained by adjusting the positions of active nodes using geometry optimization. Detail shows an element with exaggerated self-weight, demonstrating the curvature and non-uniform cross-sections of these elements. Finally, we can get the resulting optimized design for the problem. Here, we can see a simplified multi-span bridge problem, with point load applied at the center of each span. The highlighted half span can be modeled due to symmetry. The modified layout optimization procedure can be used to identify theoretical optimal forms for very long span bridges. Okay, now we move to applications. For the sake of simplicity, it is here assumed that the central span of a notational multi-span bridge structure is being modeled, with the problem being as description in last slide, but with the point loads big W replaced with a uniformly distributed load small w, applied at the same elevation. Structural forms corresponding to the new reference solutions for 1, 2.5, and 5 km span lengths. To provide visually clear solutions, a layout optimization discretization involving 30 nodal spacings across the full span was used prior to rationalizing the solutions using geometry optimization. Figure 1 shows the new reference forms, with tension and compressive elements aligned orthogonally. Figure 4 shows the resulting optimized cable stay bridge forms, and differs slightly from the standard hub cable arrangement in that they have non-uniform spacing of stays along the height of the pylon. However, the consumed material is up to 38% greater than that required for the corresponding optimal reference designs from Figure 1. Figure 2 and 3 show simplified slip pylon bridge structures comprising respectively 3 and 2 pylons consuming respectively approximately 6 and 12% more material than the corresponding reference designs in the 5 km span case. For comparative purposes, optimization suspension bridge configurations were obtained by applying geometry optimization to the standard suspension bridge layout. These bridges consume up to 73% more material than the corresponding reference designs from Figure 1. The right-hand side figure shows the results for all the cases described in normalized form, covering spans of up to 10 km when using the same steel material as assumed before. Volumes for the fan-style cable stay bridge form are also included for comparative purposes, along with those for cable stay and suspension bridge forms constrained to use the larger span-to-dip ratios currently employed in the world's current longest cable stay and suspension bridge spans respectively. Found in the 1104-meter span Ruski Bridge in Russia and the 1991-meter span Akashi Kaikyo Bridge in Japan. Traditional suspension bridges have been built with span-to-dip ratios of 8.5 to 13.5 and cable stay bridges with span-to-dip ratios of 3.4 to 4.9. From conclusions, what we learned: a means of obtaining the theoretically optimal bridge form to span a given distance under the action of gravity loading has been described. This required the development of a new numerical layout optimization procedure capable of modeling the self-weight of the constituent structural element. To achieve this, equal-strength catenary elements were employed, allowing phenomena such as cable sag to be modeled in the optimization process in an entirely natural manner. The procedure has been applied to the design of hypothetical very long span bridges, enabling the optimal reference form and associated required volume of material to be established for a given span. The reference volume provides a benchmark against which traditional or proposed new bridge designs can be objectively judged. Okay, thanks to everyone for watching my video today, and I do hope you found the video informative and that you learned some things from it. If you have any questions, then you can write comments and messages. I am happy to answer any questions. Thanks for your watching.